Hello, my name is Maxime Kepfle and I'm the CTO of Tigon. Together with the research and development team, we have been developing the Tigon platform the past few years. In this webinar, I will show you how you can import your own geodata into the Tigon platform and then connect it using WFS with an external program like QGIS or ArcGIS-Pro. Then you can also edit your data out of QGIS and load them back into the Tigon platform. I will start the webinar by showing you how to import a GeoJSON file into the program. The Tigon platform can also be used to import your own buildings into the project. For example, I have this grass field here and I want to import some new buildings there. I can go to the Geo Import button, select Import New Geodata. Then I can select buildings, but I can also import them as terrains, areas, neighborhoods, all kinds of options. I select the GeoJSON file that I have from my ArcGIS application or QGIS. Here it's selected. Now it's imported as a 3857 coordinate system and it found one feature. You can also see that on the small map here you see the buildings that will be imported. You can also additionally filter them based on a specific attribute, but I just want all the buildings. I also want to import them as new buildings. You can also update only existing attributes if you have some additional attributes of your own. But in this case, it's just a grass field, so I want to import them completely. I can give them a name based on the name attribute or on a different prefix, whatever you want. You can also import additional attributes that are in your GeoJSON file. The next thing I have to select is the function. For example, if I want to build a housing complex, I can select it with a nice green rooftop. Next. Now it's finished and it's imported to the server. And here you can see the result, my six new buildings. I can also export buildings again when I select them. Here you see my buildings. And when I just drag them, for example, to a text file, I can just take it and drop it in the text file. And here you see the original GeoJSON data again. So I can also edit my buildings using the Geo standard WFS. Using WFS, I can change the attributes of my newly added buildings or change their shape. To do this, I have to go to Buildings in the menu bar, select Export Geodata, and now I have a panel with different options. So I can select the WFS, for example, and I can select it on all buildings or maybe only agricultural buildings or only bridges or roads. For now I select all and I select the WFS service. This is using copy URL. Now the URL of the WFS server is copied to my clipboard and I can open it in, for example, QGIS. So when I open QGIS next to my project, I can do layer, add layer, add WFS layer, and here I can edit in my URL. I press OK, connect, and you see all the different layers that are in this WFS service. Here I select all buildings again. I can also select again only the roads. Press add, and now you can see all the buildings in my project using WFS. So here are the six buildings that I just entered. I can click on them and I can get more information. I can see the different attributes, but I can also edit the attributes using this button. I can go, for example, to the roof color, and now it's the default color that's green in this example, but I can also change it to have a red colored roof. So I change it to the RGB code for red, select OK, and now save it. And you see that's updated in the Tigon project immediately. I can also do more. For example, I can also edit the the contour of the building. So when I want to extend this building with a nice extension, I can just edit it here. And when I press save again, you see that's also extended very largely in the Tigon software. So in the previous part, you saw that I added some new buildings in my project using VFS. I've reverted the changes again and back to the original buildings. And we can now also look at the impact of these new houses, for example, on the water flow in the area. So when I go to overlays and I select rainfall overlay, I can see where the water is flowing when there's a lot of rain showers in the area. And you can see that this specific house really has a problem because there's a lot of water directly in front of it. So these overlays, you can see them in the Tigon project, but you can also see them again in QGIS. I will demonstrate that now. You go to the rainfall overlay and you select export grid data. And here you get a new panel with what you want to export. You can export it as a GeoTIFF and then again import it into QGIS. You can also download all the frames in one action. But there's also a new option available, and that's using the webmap service. Again, you select copy URL. Now it's copied to my clipboard and I can open it in QGIS. So here I have my project again with the buildings in QGIS. And I can do layer, add VMS layer. And here I select edit. I enter the URL. Okay. And I'm connecting, you see the different overlays in my project. When I select the overlays and then go to the rainfall overlay, I can also select the last time frame. And when I add it to my project, you can see the rainfall overlay in QGIS. And you can see that this specific building really has a problem, because if you walk outside the door here, then you're wet. You can also click on it. You can get more information about that specific area. So for example, the amount of water that's there, it's 20 centimeters, it's quite a lot. Now the next interesting thing is that I can also make some changes to this building. So for example, I can put it on a hilltop. When I go back to the Tigon engine, I can go to terrain. And now to select, it's the wrong one. I can do change elevation model. And here I have some new different options and I can make a selection based on the blueprint. For example, from an area that I made before. So when I put, what I would do next is that I will put some height around the building so it's protected against the water. And you can set all these things down here. You can set, for example, the angle. So if you want a little slope to protect the building, or if you want it straight up. And you can select the height of how the change in the land height. And you can do an absolute value and set it to a specific value, or you can do it relative to the existing height map. So what I will do is that I will give it a 45% angle and make it 10 meters higher than the original. Then I select apply and apply changes. And now you can see that the building is standing on top of a small hill. And I go back to overlays, to the rainfall overlay, and I select update. And it needs to calculate a bit, and it will calculate new situation with my house standing on the hilltop. It's finished in a few seconds. Yes, now you can see that the water is flowing around it and not into my house. Again, I can also show this in QGIS. I just have to select refresh and you see that the water is nicely flowing around the building instead of right through it. And I can also show this data, for example, in the Esri environment. That can be done via the web interface and show it in ArcGIS viewer. And here you see my area again, and I can select the last time frame. And you see the water in the Esri environment. Okay, thank you for watching this webinar. I hope you have enjoyed it. I would suggest playing around with these features, because then you will understand them even better. I hope to see you next year. Goodbye.